Hello and welcome to this review of Speechelo. So what is Speechelo? Well, Speechelo is very simply text-to-speech software. You type in text here, you press a button, and guess what? You get speech. You get a computer speaking in lots and lots of different voices across lots of different languages, and you can download that file as an MP3 and you can use it wherever you want. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to explain what Speechelo is using Speechelo.
Speechelo is cloud-based software that allows you to create MP3 voice files from text. You can create speech using different voices, and you can add effects like breathing, pauses, and word emphasis to make the speech seem more real or more engaging to listen to. The software costs $27 as a one-time fee. There are a few upgrade options.
So that was quite a good demonstration of what Speechelo is capable of. So let's get into Speechelo. Let's firstly talk about how much it costs. Now, Speechelo costs $27 as a one-time fee. You also get a 60-day money-back guarantee if you don't like it. I'm not an ambassador for Speechelo, and I paid for this software myself, and I have the Pro version. Now, I got the Pro version a long time ago, but it looks like the Pro version costs $47. I bought my Speechelo a long time ago, so I don't know what it is now, but just looking at the sales page, it looks like it's another $47 four times a year. So up here, you can see I've got Speechelo and Speechelo Pro, and there are other upgrades. You can upgrade to Worldwide, and that does translations. I've not upgraded to that, and I don't have any interest in that. So let's look at how we use Speechelo, what we can get from it, and if it's any good. The first choice is your language. So I'm actually British. I'm based in the UK, so I can pick English British. In fact, I can pick quite a lot of variants of English. I could go for Australian. I could go for Irish, Canadian, or US, or even Welsh. Dylan for Welsh. You've got a preview button here, so let's just have a listen to Dylan.
Hi, my name is Dylan. I'm a native English speaker.
That's enough for Dylan. And let's compare him to someone from Britain, although Wales is in Britain. We're not going to go into that. Let's compare him to Arthur.
Hi, my name is Arthur.
Now, Arthur's voice is Brian in other software. We've got standard and we've got AI voices. Let's say, for example, we wanted to pick a female Australian. We could have Sophie.
Hi, my name is Sophie. I am a native English speaker.
Now, I think the Australian ones are weirdly very accurate.
Hi, my name is Hayden. I am a native English speaker.
So let's say we really like the voice of Hayden. All we have to do is type our text in and press a button, and we get an MP3 file generated. It really is that easy. I'm going to type away and we'll come back once I've done my typing. So we're back. I've typed something out. You could equally paste something. I get 20,000 characters. I'm never going to use that up. And if you did go over, you could just generate another file and link it up in your post-production. I could click generate voiceover and that would be fine, probably. There are a few things that you need to be aware of in general when using TTS software. If when you type it out, you make a mistake, you'll hear it back. Also, punctuation plays a really important point. I think punctuation plays more of an important part than using these adjustments here. So I probably want to punctuate here. Hello, I want a little pause there, but not enough that I need to go and use the add pause button. I'm interested in buying tech. Oh, see, I've made a mistake. I put test to speech. So I'm going to put text to speech software or TTS. Now, I don't know how this is going to sound. I might need to put spaces in. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to preview it and we'll see if I need to put spaces in.
Hello, I am interested in buying text-to-speech software or TTS for short.
Now, that was really good. In the AI avatar software I use, I'd have to space that out. Otherwise, it would try and say TTS in a different way. Now, what I might want to do is I might want to put an exclamation mark in there just to emphasize that. I might just want to capitalize that. I'm not sure if it's going to make any difference. Now, all I need to do is click generate voice over. Let's go. So it really doesn't take very long to generate a voice file. It's done in a couple of seconds and it appears down here. So I'm going to play it.
Hello, I am interested in buying text-to-speech software or TTS for short. I don't know which one to buy. Big G Video makes videos about making videos for YouTube. He has made a review of Revoicer and ProfitVoice and makes lots of videos about AI avatar software, or text-to-video software.
So I can click here, and that's going to show me the whole of my text, and I can copy it to clipboard if I want to. I'm going to close that. I mean, I'm quite happy with that. That's pretty good. Well done, Hayden. You've done a good job. I'm particularly happy how it handled things like TTS and how it handled things in brackets and AI. I can't really fault it. Now, what I can do, if I really wanted to make it sound more authentic, and again, this is a bit subjective because I'm not sure these things are going to make it sound more authentic, but I can add breathing. I'm going to click emphasize this. I think the breathing's quite good. I don't think the emphasized words are very good. So I'm going to put the emphasized words in here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to just this last bit, I'm going to adjust the speech. So I'm going to make it louder. I'm going to make it faster. And sadly, I'm going to lower its pitch. If I wanted to add a pause, I could click add a pause and I can pick how many seconds it pauses for. So let's say I want to insert 2 second pause. It does that. I'm going to take that out. I don't want a 2 second pause, but that's how you would do it. So I'm going to generate that and we're going to listen to it. Again, it's generated really quickly. Let's listen to it.
Hello. I am interested in buying text-to-speech software, or TTS for short. I don't know which one to buy. Big G Video makes videos about making videos for YouTube. He has made a review of Revoicer and ProfitVoice and makes lots of videos about AI avatar software, or text-to-video software.
So, you could hear the breathing at the start. It was very subtle, and actually, I missed it the first time. I had to play it again. Like I said, I don't think the emphasis is very good, but certainly, making it louder, making it faster, and making it lower certainly worked, and I know pauses work as well. So if you want to go and add emphasis, you can use punctuation, because otherwise it just reads it all out and it really doesn't sound particularly natural. Or you can add these things in, and they are nice touches. And don't forget, this is $27. I know I've got the pro version. That I think that just gives me more voices and more characters. So other things we can do is, once we've made our file, we can go and add music to it. So let's add music track. So if we click add music track, it takes us here to this screen that we could get to via the menu, background music. It's retained the speech from before. It's got Hayden. But if we just went here cold, we would have to go and load a custom file. Let's look at this Adventure Time. It's upbeat but serious. We can play it to see if we like it. I love that. That's going to go so well with Hayden's voice. In case we couldn't work out what it is by listening to it, there are some icons here that tell us it's all happy and family and a little bit cheeky here. Because I played Adventure Time, it's put it up here. We can load custom files. And then I just have to click the generate button. Now, it's going to merge those two together. So I'm going to call it Hayden with BG Music. And it's going to stop when it gets to the end of Hayden's speech. So it's merging, and it will be really quick. And you can see I've done a few here. So it's now taken us to this generated audio background music. We've just got to wait a little bit for it to do its thing. And we're back. It's done. It really didn't take that long. Let's listen to Hayden with background music.
Hello. I am interested in buying text-to-speech software, or TTS for short. I don't know which one to buy. Big G Video makes videos about making videos for YouTube. He has made a review of Revoicer and ProfitVoice and makes lots of videos about AI avatar software, or text-to-video software.
So that's that. So we can easily add in background music. The thing is, if you're going to be making things that contain TTS, you're probably going to be using a video audio editor anyway. So it's a very nice feature, and I guess it has its use and it's nice to have, but probably you would have that facility anyway. So of course, I don't think I said we can adjust the volume of each if we don't like it, if we think we want the voice to be really loud but the background music to be slightly quiet. At the moment, they're equally matched. So I'm going to go back to voice generation. So that is Speechelo. That's what it does. You've got many different English voices, but you've also got voices from other languages, and they will speak the language that you put in. However, if you type in English to a non-English language, it will translate it to that language.
Hello, I am English.
I don't know if that's an accurate translation because I don't speak Italian, but people may find that useful. When making things in Speechelo, I haven't found any bugs. Speechelo has been around for a while. They've got all the bugs sorted out, which is really nice. Sometimes when you use this type of software, you encounter bugs and that can be frustrating. In my using Speechelo, I've never found any bugs at all.